Alright guys, up at the shop on Sunday. That means things are about to go down. Alright, time to, what the heck? The heck is going on over here? Light been on all weekend? I hope not. Turn that off, we'll fix that up. Go ahead and turn this one off. I don't know what happened here, but somebody had a Bloody Mary. Thanks for tuning in, guys. We're making it work, and I'm Jimmy if you're new here. I got some cool tools I want to show you guys. Thanks for tuning in. A couple of little things I got planned. I'll show you what I got. First things first, we got to let the sun shine in. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, sneak peek. All right, guys, another metalworking tool haul. So I'm going to show you guys real quick what I got before I start on the project video. One of the things I got, which I thought was pretty cool, is this little hole plug magnet. You know, everyone knows copper and aluminum the MIG welder won't weld to. But I saw this in searching for some scrap copper I was going to use, and I saw this tool look pretty cool. It actually has a magnetic base that you can put on any piece of steel you're going to be welding. And it comes with a spring-loaded... Oh, that's got to cut all the way across. And it comes with a spring-loaded arm so that you can put some tension on this block. See how that works? The block is tensioned so you don't have to hold it while you're working. You don't have to hold this piece. You don't have to put clamps on it or anything. You just stick it on your panel. I'll show you. If I wanted to weld these holes closed, well, first of all, I have to have access from the back. Yeah, there's none back here I can do. Let's say I wanted to weld this seam, this magnet, orient it how you need it. There you go. Now you got that piece of copper behind there, and I can weld this across. And then when I'm done, just pull this back off. The weld's not going to stick to it. Now you could also clamp it with some channel locks, vice grips, whatever you want to use. You could clamp it with some vice grips to hold this piece of copper behind it while you work. But sometimes you just don't have the luxury. There's no room. So I thought the magnetic thing would be kind of cool. Another tool in the arsenal, and this also adjusts. So you can turn it wherever you need to orient it. It slides. It's got a slot in it. So that was pretty cool. Come in handy. Another metal working tool I got. You guys recommended this. A lot of body guys watch my videos, and I love the input from the more experienced guys. That's how I found out about this. I mean, I've watched videos on it, but I never had gone through the trouble of picking one up. But this tool here. Ooh, that's a good staple. These are Mayhew. So they're made in the US of A. See right here. Made in the US of A. So my old biker buddies and my Schmuckatelli buddies, they're all going to be happy. This is all USA stuff. No Chinese tool reviews here, guys. But what these are is spot weld breakers. So you can use it as a chisel leading into a spot weld, or you can use the side of it and you can actually hammer on the other side, and you can pop spot welds loose that you can't quite get if they won't drill out clean. Sometimes a spot weld's a little ugly and it's kind of shaped like a figure eight, stuff like that. That's what these are for. And I got something else I want to show you guys. Toughbuilt sawhorses. I noticed working on my panels, on those cheap floppy wooden ones that wobble around a lot, they're also too low. So I'm hoping these are going to be quite a bit higher, at least 5 or 6 inches higher, because it's hard on the back when you're bending over a long period of time and you're like in that prone position, like you're working to get cigarettes in prison or whatever. You put a lot of tension on your back. So that's what these are going to do. Let's open them up. Stop making jokes, Mr. Funny Guy. Oh, somehow I thought they'd each have their own box inside the box. I guess not. Toughbuilt. They're pretty heavy. I mean, these are not light-duty sawhorses. If you're just looking for something light to cut a couple 2x4s, these are overkill. But for what I'm doing, they're going to be perfect. Let me set you guys down. I'll show you what they look like. All right, let's throw this all over here out of the way. That's they look like set up together. Pretty robust, heavy duty, much taller than the stubby little wobbly guys. The body shop sawhorse actually works really well. It's kind of light duty, but it actually doesn't fold out to the right dimensions to clear the wheel well. So I need two of those, and half of them will be sticking out. So I saw these as the best option. I can use it for home projects and stuff too. Very well built, sturdy. A little bit clumsy opening them up. Quite a bit complicated to figure out till you've opened and closed them a few times. One side has to close first. It says open first, close first. So it tells you, fine print, open first, close first. Because one of them's above, one of them's below. Then of course you gotta ratchet your leg height, set your locks. But I mean, these things are super, super sturdy. I could do push-ups on them, no problem. You wanna see? Give you guys an idea how sturdy these are. Let's do some push-ups on them. I haven't done push-ups in a while. Getting out of shape. Yep. These things are great. They're gonna be good. Well guys, now that I got my workout in, got my tool video done, I appreciate you watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you're looking for information on these C700 Toughbuilt sawhorses or spot weld cutting tools and welding tools and things like that, I'm a little out of breath from 10 push-ups. I got a bunch of videos on tools. I got videos on metalworking tools. Most of my videos are mechanics tools. But since I've got this project behind me here, a lot of them have gone towards metalworking and bodywork stuff. So bear with me if you're not into that kind of thing. We'll be back to automotive repair tools soon. You guys are awesome. I'll see you in the next video.